be a first. You know, my driver's name is Gert, and his the names of his two donkeys. This one is called Melkmaze because of the color. He said it's a lighter color.
Yeah.
And I don't know if the SABC will appreciate it, but he told me the name of the other one is Mnet because there will be cameras here today.
This is Mnet, not SABC. Can we christen him SABC, Gert? Yeah, no, he can't. I can't eat it done. Minister, we spoke about this back in Clarence. We were off air. You were saying there's a little community in Wuppertal, which I'd never heard of. And you mentioned saying that would be a brilliant broadcast if we could get cameras out here and show this to South Africa to see what they're missing out on. And here we are. It's happening.
You know, Lihan, every year, millions of people from all over the world, the United States, Germany, China, they visit our country. And South Africans as well, they go to Cape Town, they visit the waterfront, Table Mountain, they go to Durban, visit the beaches, they go to Mpumalanga and Limpopo, go to Kruger National Park, but there's so much more. And our new rural strategy is really to unlock the tourism potential in the rural areas in our country. So we want to see improved cooperation between the different spheres of government, but as government, we also want to invest and work with local communities to fully unlock that potential.
Yeah, I mean, okay, this is what we hear really doing today is that whole the rural projects in South Africa. How important is it? Because tourism into rural areas has to be the heart of a country, because these are the people. This is what it's really like. The cities are one aspect, but this is the larger population.
Yes, people are looking for the undiscovered jewels. That's what people want nowadays.
Yeah.
And after they've seen what they normally go to a country for, they want to see how ordinary people live, and they want to go to those wide open spaces. And if you just look at this area, the majestic mountains here in the Cederberg, the landscape, the people, warm people, hospitality, and that's what people want. So in the first phase of this project, we invested just over 11 million rand. It may not sound a lot of money, but for the local community here and creating jobs, it's absolutely crucial. And in the next phase, we're going to invest a further 20 million rand. But we want to work with the community, and what we will use that money for is constructing bridges, making this area accessible, building guest houses, and then develop what you refer to, the three-day donkey trek route.
Yes.
So that will be a unique experience.
Why Wuppertal? Why is it so close to you? Because like I said, this is something that I could see when you spoke about it, you felt passionate about this area.
There's a history to this area, and it's only 4 hours drive from Cape Town. Yes, I heard you said earlier a little
it's
bit
a
of a
hectic
bumpy
drive.
Road.
Yeah.
And but it is accessible, and there's already something here. This mission station here is something special. The way of life is something special. This is the way that people have been living for generations, and it is still here. And we want to preserve this, but we want to enable people to make a living for themselves. And tourism will bring people here. We will build guest houses here. It will create jobs, and people will be able to put bread on the table, pay their school fees, send their children to university. That's what it should be about.
You know, what I found fascinating is when I was doing a little bit of homework before I got here, and put the word Wuppertal into Google, the most incredible articles came up, but all the articles are from international tourists that have been here. And when I'm chatting to some of the community members, they say mostly the tourists that come here are from overseas. I don't know if many locals take advantage of this beauty.
You are absolutely right. And the international tourists who come here are mostly German because of the German history of this mission station. South Africans don't know Wuppertal and Eerlem and Genadendal. That's what we should tell people about. But the first phase of our strategy will focus on 5 areas in the country. The West Coast region here in the Western Cape, the Maluti-Drakensberg, the Karoo, which covers 4 provinces, and then in the province of Mpumalanga, Bushbuck Ridge, and in Limpopo, the northern part, Vembe. That's what we will focus on in the first phase. Invest money there, work with local communities, invest in infrastructure, and we have absolutely no doubt people will go there once they are aware these areas are accessible and there are facilities there.
All right, Minister, thank you for talking to us. Your ride awaits you, I imagine. There's Gert waiting for you patiently to take you back somewhere. I don't know where, but I can tell you one thing, the sinuses are getting to me, and I think it's not from this one, it's from Mnet over there.
Thank you very
I'm going to start sneezing soon. Thanks for being here with us again, Minister of Tourism, Martinus van Schalkwyk, about to get back.